Hello and welcome to the session. In this session, first we are going to discuss geometrical conditions required to determine a circle. Circle has two forms of equation. One is the standard form and the other is the general form. And in each form, the equation of a circle has three independent arbitrary constants. We obtain the equation of a circle if we know the values of these three constants . As there are three variables, so we need three equations or conditions about the circle to find the value of these constants. Let us discuss a few geometrical conditions. First is, three points are given through which the circle passes. Second is, two points are given on the circle and a line on which its center lies and third is, central line, point and radius etc. are given. With each of these conditions, three equations can be formed. Let us now discuss how to find the equation of the circle using the given condition. Let the required equation of the circle be x square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. Next is to establish three equations. In g, f and c, using the three given conditions, like if we are given with three points say A1 A2 B1 B2 C1 C2 then put these points one by one in the equation of the circle . Then we shall get three algebraic equations in G, F and C. Next we have, if we are given with two points a line on which its center lies say x plus y plus d is equal to 0 where d is any constant, then we put two points one by one in the equation of the circle . With this we get two equations with three variables G, F and C. Now, at the center of the circle, lies on the line x plus y plus d is equal to 0, therefore the center, that is GF, will lie on it, therefore we shall have one more equation in the form of G and F, by having three algebraic equations in three variables . We can find their values . Next is with central line point and radius etc. given . We can find three algebraic equations in G, F and C . And by solving these three equations . We can have the values of G, F and C . Then substitute the values of G, F and C . Then we will have the required equation of the circle . Let us now discuss the intersection of a line and a circle . The points of intersection of a line and a circle can be obtained by solving the equations of the line and the circle. Let us discuss how to solve the equations of a line and a circle. Let the line given by x minus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0 cuts the circle x square plus y square is equal to 10. Now we have to find their points of intersection, and we take the following steps. First we eliminate y or x. Whichever is simpler. In this, we find the value of x in terms of y from the equation of the line x minus 2y plus 1 is equal to 0, which implies that x is equal to 2y minus 1. Now, we substitute this value of x. In the equation of the circle, the equation of the circle is given by x square plus y square is equal to 10. Now we put the value of x is equal to 2y minus 1 in this equation, and we get 2y minus 1 the whole square plus y square is equal to 10, which can be written as 4y square plus 1 minus 4y plus y square is equal to 10. That is 4y square plus y square minus 4y plus 1 minus 10 is equal to 0, and therefore we get 5y square minus 4y minus 9 is equal to 0, and thus we get a quadratic equation in y. Now let us solve this quadratic equation in y. So that we will have the values of y. We have the equation 5y square minus 4y minus 9 is equal to 0, which can be written as 5y square minus 9y plus 5y minus 9 is equal to 0. Now taking y common from the first two terms, we get y into 5y minus 9 plus, taking 1 common from the last two terms, we get 1 into 5y minus 9 is equal to 0, and therefore we get y plus 1 into 5y minus 9 is equal to 0. If we have y plus 1 is equal to 0, it implies that y is equal to minus 1, and if we have 5y minus 9 is equal to 0, it implies that 5y is equal to 9, that is y is equal to 9 by 5. Therefore, y plus 1 into 5y minus 9 is equal to 0 implies that y is equal to minus 1 and y is equal to 9 upon 5. Now the fourth step is, let us substitute these two values of y in the equation of line to have the two corresponding values of x. Then Therefore, for y is equal to minus 1, we have x which is equal to 2y minus 1 can be written as 2 into minus 1 minus 1, that is 2 into minus 1 is minus 2 minus 1 which is equal to minus 3, and for y is equal to 9 upon 5, x is equal to 2 into 9 upon 5 minus 1, that is 2 into 9, that is 18 upon 5 minus 1, which is equal to 18 minus 5 by 5, that is 13 upon 5. We now have two pairs of values, that is minus 3 minus 1 and 13 by 5, 9 by 5. And these are the points of intersection of the line x minus 2y plus 1 with the circle x square plus y square is equal to 10. We can also determine the length of the intercept formed by the points minus 3 minus 1 and 13 by 5, 9 by 5 by applying distance formula. We get the length of the intercept is equal to square root of minus 3 minus 13 by 5 the whole square plus minus 1 minus 9 by 5 the whole square, which is equal to square root of minus 15 minus 13 by 5 the whole square plus minus 5 minus 9 by 5 the whole square, which is equal to square root of minus 15 minus 13 is minus 28 by 5 the whole square plus minus 5 minus 9 is minus 14 by 5 the whole square. So this is equal to square root of minus 28 square is 784 by 5 square, that is 25, plus minus 14 square, that is 196 upon 5 square, that is 25. So we get square root of 980 by 25, which is equal to 196 by 5. And therefore we get square root of 196 by 5 is equal to 14 upon square root of 5, which can also be written as 14 into square root of 5 by 5. Therefore, length of the intercept is given by (5) by 5 units. This completes our session. Hope you enjoyed this session.